thousands of...
Live from the Hornet's Nest on the campus of Sacramento State, it's time for NCAA Gymnastics for tonight. The Seawolves of the University of Alaska-Anchorage take on the Sacramento State Hornets. Brian Berger joined alongside former Sacramento State gymnast Dallas Smith. And tonight, a couple of teams that are coming in, both looking to try to get on the right track. Sacramento State has had two meets this year. They have scored 191.375 in the season opener, raised that up to 192.4 last week in a 14 meet at Oregon State, which also included number 18 Oregon State and number 8 Denver. Hornets also lost to Brown in that contest. They come in 0-4. Alaska Anchorage has had a pair of home meets. They scored 189.175, 188.725 in a couple of matchups against Westchester, which took place in Alaska on January 13th and 15th. So, Dallas, two teams that have had a couple of meets under their belt. Neither one of them probably terribly happy with where they stand, but both looking for some consistency here in the early part of the season.
Absolutely. A bit rocky start for both teams, but like you said, it is early in the season. There is an opportunity for both teams to get some momentum early in the year. Both teams have had their struggles on events, and there's a lot of opportunity for the teams to put together an entire rotation, an entire meet, and really see those scores skyrocket.
Sacramento State has had some consistency issues, mostly in the middle part of the meet on bars and beam. And interesting enough, it's kind of been a hodgepodge of who's had success and who hasn't. The first meet, it was kind of three up, three down for Sacramento State. The next week, it was the opposite. So on the bright side, the athletes have shown that they can have the consistency, they can put the produce the marks that can score points. The downside is right now no one is 100% been reliable in those two meets. And from a gymnast standpoint, how much does that go in psychologically right now? Where you kind of, is everyone present at this point of the year, or do you have to kind of take it meet by meet?
I think a little bit of both. Like you said, it's encouraging because no one has had bad meets in both meets. They have shown that they can have success, they can be mentally strong. It's just a matter of having the team camaraderie, the team spirit behind everyone, really building off of that momentum, routine after routine, event after event. So I think that there is a lot of opportunity. They show a lot of promise, and hopefully we'll see that all put together tonight.
Tonight is parents' night as well as kids' night here at the Nest. So you will see the Hornets come out in their march in just a minute. A lot of them joined by their parents who are in town visiting. It's an interesting weekend for Sacramento State. They compete tonight here at home against the Nest, against Alaska Anchorage, and then they will go on the road on Sunday down to San Jose State, take on Wisconsin Lacrosse. Alaska Anchorage also in a similar boat. They will take on UC Davis and Air Force on Sunday. For Sacramento State, though, first time they've had two meets in a three-day span since 2013. It's been quite a long time. What's that do for you competitively?
It is challenging for sure. I was a part of that 2013 team that had those back-to-back meets. Fortunately for us, it was a little bit later in our season and you could rest some of those key players. I don't know if that's going to be the case for Sacramento State this weekend. Again, looking to build that momentum, they'll try to, you know, really work through their lineups, try to get those scores moving in the right direction. It is really challenging, though, on your body. It is challenging mentally. It really is a true test to that mental fortitude to see who can show up and who can remain consistent in back-to-back meets.
Sacramento State head coach Randy Solario has talked about the depth of this team, and they will make some changes on floor between tonight and Sunday, trying to keep everybody fresh there. But injuries starting to become a factor, too, for the Hornets. They've lost a couple of gymnasts right now. Olivia Schmidt, the freshman, went down in practice a couple last week, and then also Kelly McLeod. And so on top of that, Caitlin Searle, who's lost for the year. And so now you're starting to get into a little bit of a numbers game. But for the Hornets, this format is something that you're seeing now in the NCAAs. If the team, any team that advances in NCAA regionals, it's now a competition where you have to compete on back-to-back nights. So I think you'll start seeing more and more teams go to this two meets and three-day span just to try to get a little bit of a taste for the postseason. But it's something a lot of schools had gone away from for a long time.
Yeah, like I said, it's really hard on your body. You definitely don't look forward to putting your body through that. But it is a great test, like you mentioned, for the NCAA postseason. So for teams that, you know, have that trajectory, I think it is a great opportunity to get that under your belt to kind of test how you're going to show up night after night, meet after meet. So hopefully the Hornets can really showcase some of that strength this weekend.
Yeah, actually it will be three meets in 8 days for Sacramento State, as they'll be back on it as well against at Air Force on February 3rd. So a busy week of competition. But if things start to click and they start putting it together, sometimes you want those competitions back to back to back and try to get the momentum rolling and get back on the right track for Sacramento State. They're just now finishing marching here on a busy night. Sacramento State will open up the meet on vault. That has been their strongest event of the year so far. Hornets have come in averaging 48.413. It ranks them third in the NPSF this year. They have scored 48.475 in the season opener. 48.35 is the only event in which the team has broken 48 points in the first two meets. And obviously at home, you're back in Olympic water, something just a little more familiar from as a gymnast standpoint?
Absolutely, especially because they've had a lot of success on vault this season. To open with their strongest event first, it really is an opportunity for them to build that momentum. I think it's very encouraging that their vault is going in that direction of higher start values, higher scores. It's a great opportunity for them to build tonight.
Yeah, you've seen a lot of variety in the vault so far from Sacramento State this year. And Morgenthaler has been the leader so far this year on vault. She is tied for second in the NPSF this year with an average of 9.8. And so expect a lot of power from Emma as she will go in the back half of the lineup for the Hornets. In fact, she will anchor today. It'll be Bella Lamitti for Sacramento State leading off, followed by Sarah Fitzgerald, Tori Tavner, Rylan Zimmerman, Sarah Luttrell, and then Emma Morgenthaler. No exhibition for Sacramento State here in this first rotation. And then for Alaska over on bars, they will start with Alyssa Manley, Allie McClure, Emily Walker, Haley Perkins, Paolo Rano Barona, Rachel Decius, and then Brianne Spain will do the exhibition for the Seawolves. Alaska, as we said, really had some tough times at home. They opened up against Westchester back-to-back meets. They have a very light schedule, and almost all of them are on quick turnarounds like you're seeing Sacramento State. They open with Westchester on back-to-back or a day in between. And then here in the Northern California trip, Sacramento State and then at UC Davis Sunday. Then back at home for two against William and Mary on February 3rd and 5th. Then they will go to Simpson and Iowa State, both in the state of Iowa, on February 17th and 19th. Then a trip to Utah for BYU and Utah State on the 1st and the 3rd. And they will end the season at the NPSF Championships at Air Force. And so Alaska should be very familiar with this format of going in these back-to-backs, and obviously for them, a lot of it's logistically. When you were competing, did you guys ever make that trip up there?
We did. My senior year, we were able to go up to Alaska for the NPSF Conference Championships. It was a beautiful campus, a wonderful experience, but yes, it is a little bit difficult logistically to get up there, so it makes a lot of sense why they have a lot of those back-to-back meets. I also think logistics changed a little bit in the past few years of college athletics. You see a lot of teams kind of make the most of their trips and the travel situations.
Sacramento State going through their warm-ups. Alaska about to start theirs as well. We will take a quick break. We'll come back for the start of the first rotation. It'll be Sacramento State on vault and Alaska Anchorage on bars. You're watching Hornet Gymnastics on ESPN Plus. Back here at the Nest, teams going through their final bit of touch warm-ups. Alaska finishing over on bar. Sacramento State getting ready on vault. You've had a chance to watch a little bit of both teams so far. Hornets on vault, you talked about it before. That's their strongest event. What have you seen so far?
Absolutely. Like I said in the opening, it's great to see the Hornets adding star value to their vaults. It's been a weak spot in recent years, building in last year and even more so this year, seeing a lot of those Yurchenko folds, a lot of height off the table, and a few less variety, I think, than we've seen in a couple past seasons. We've seen the Hornets do some unique vaults. I think we'll see a little bit less of that tonight and more traditional Yurchenko folds.
Start values up to, I believe that's a 9.9 start value now. Those of you not familiar with college gymnastics, start value is the maximum score a gymnast can receive and then deductions taken off from that point. But watching a little bit of some interesting bar work on your Alaska-Anchorage as they're adjusting the bars while they have a gymnast on top of it. But start values in the past, the Hornets have had start values as low as 9.8 on vault. As you said, they've really raised that level of difficulty up to a 9.9 for most of them, which allows for a higher score if it's executed properly. But for Sacramento State, you said a lot more of that Yurchenko full, which has kind of become the standard in gymnastics right now across the board, with the exception of some of the former Olympians, which are doing whatever they want. We saw last week with Jade Carey for Oregon State, but it's been an interesting change in dynamics of college gymnastics, along with the scoring, the start value. Scores up across the nation very high this year. We've seen a lot of the power schools scoring in that 198 plus range, which is just truly incredible.
It is very impressive when you watch gymnastics across the country. It's always been a sport about perfection, but even more so now, you see a lot of those big teams doing exactly what they should, high-flying skills, hitting the handstands on certain events, adding that charisma throughout the dance and the performance, and then, of course, those stuck landings. All things that we will hope to see from the Hornets tonight as well.
Bella Lamidi will go first for Sacramento State on vault.
These leadoff positions are so important. It's great to see somebody with experience in this leadoff spot. Bella has that, competing previously on vault for the Hornets.
Bella was a scratch just before that first meet, 9.675 last week.
Starts the meet off with a huge Yurchenko tuck full. A bit of a big hop back on the landing. That'll be a little bit of a deduction, but a strong start to lead things off.
One for one for Sacramento State. They'll now switch over to bars. This will be Alyssa Manley.
We will be looking for handstands on bars. Good body position. Alyssa starts off with a beautiful combination, full pirouette to that big release. Beautiful handstand right there. Really strong start so far. Just the dismount left. Again, beautiful handstands. Pirouette into a double pike. Tiny, tiny hop. That is an amazing start for the Seawolves on bars.
Both teams with their first routine under their belt, both executed well. We'll wait the scores and give them to you as they come in. And now for Sacramento State, they'll go back on vault. This will be Sarah Fitzgerald. Looks like it's going to be a 9.7, if I read the flashers correctly, for Lamidi on vault. That will be a season high. Sarah Fitzgerald this year has competed twice on vault for Sacramento State. 9.65 in both, and Sarah always has a knack for being stuck on the runway before every event, it seems like the judges confer. This time, not too bad. She'll get ready to go.
One unique vault for the Hornets, it's that Yurchenko full onto the table, tuck off. So like most gymnasts you'll see compete that full in the second flip off the table. Sarah chooses to do it onto the table. A little bit more challenging, in my opinion, but she executes it very well.
And that one, she veered off a little bit to the left side of the table. You can see those landing lines right there. Slight deduction there as well.
Yes, about a tenth deduction. Took a small step, so probably another tenth. She was very close, though, so maybe just a half attempt for the 1 foot out.
It's a vault that doesn't get a lot of distance to it, which I know the judges are looking for. but it just naturally doesn't come with that because of the way it goes off the table?
Totally. You come in at that really high angle, so you don't get a lot of opportunity to what we call in gymnastics block off the table, which is what propels you to get that height in the distance.
So a little bit different. We talked about the variety. That is one unique one that Dallas mentioned compared to the other vaults you'll see from Sacramento State. Still waiting for the score to go up on bars for the Seawolves, waiting to get the green light to go as Allie McClure. We await the score for Alyssa Manley. We are going to try to alternate tonight, allow you to see all the routines, but sometimes that doesn't work out so well. Last meet, we lasted all of one routine before the judges had two going at the same time.
Allie McClure on bars, a little bit of a slow start. She started with that chaposh up to the high bar, didn't quite get a big enough swing, had to take an extra. That will be a deduction just for that break in momentum. And again there, just wasn't quite able to keep that big swing, get the momentum. Is not able to hang on to the dismount. That will definitely be a routine that Alaska looks to drop the score.
Sarah Fitzgerald, a 9.875, or excuse me, 9.75. She had a 9.8 and a 9.7 were her scores.
A strong start for the Hornets. Anytime you can see those scores build routine after routine, that is a promising sign.
Tori Tavner next up.
Right back to that Yurchenko layout full. Another pretty big step back on the landing. The one thing that the Hornets and really any team across the country early on in the year looks to clean up, those small little details. The landings are so important.
And really for the judges, it's the easiest deduction to see. Sometimes in competition, the skills are coming so fast, you can miss something. Landings, you can't really hide them.
Absolutely, and depending upon what angle you're at, we're sitting at the opposite end of the runway from the vault, so we can see, you know, some of that leg separation that may get missed from the judges sitting on the side, but everyone can notice that landing.
It'll be Emily Walker for the Seawolves up third as they await the score from Allie McClure. And then for the Hornets, it will be the freshman Rylan Zimmerman up for Sacramento State so far, 3 for 3. He said vault has been their strongest event of the year through two meets, obviously early in the season, but it has been their most consistent. And the Hornets so far off to a good start as they have hit all three.
And you will see a lot of power in the back half of this Hornet lineup on vault. You'll see much bigger blocks off the table, which means more height, more distance. We're just hoping for those stuck landings, really add that exclamation point on some really beautiful gymnastics to come.
Emily Walker getting the last bit of advice from her coach, motivation, and she'll get ready to step on.
Seawolves will look for Emily here to restart their lineup, so to speak, after that miss on the second rotation. Unfortunately, just didn't get quite enough height, just a little too much distance on that release move.
So she will step off, give herself a chance to regroup. Now back on. I know bars, not one of your regular events, but how tough is that to get back on after a fall?
It is very hard. Not only is it hard mentally, but you lose all of the momentum. Bars is all about the rhythm, all about that beautiful swing. And anytime you have to muscle things, it just makes it much more tiring, harder to hit those handstands, make the routine as perfect as you know how to do, when it just loses that swing and that momentum. But that's why I did not compete, because she hopped right back up and had a solid second half of that routine.
So the Seawolves will be counting a fall here in the first rotation on bar. Sacramento State received a 9.675 from Tori Tavner. That is their third score. Now will be Rylan Zimmerman up, the freshman from Washington.
Again, a lot of power on this vault. Right back. Supposed to be that Yurchenko layout full. Unfortunately, she's just a little bit off and did not twist that flip.
So what will that do to your start value there in a vault like that?
That's probably a start value of around a 9.5. And if you're familiar or unfamiliar with college gymnastics, in order to be competitive and get to those high 48 or 49, you really want to score in the 9.8 range. So with a start value that isn't even up to that score, it's almost like a fall.
The Hornets will hope to not count that score from Zimmerman. It will go now back to bars for Haley Perkins. We're still awaiting the score from Emily Walker as well. Hornets currently sitting at 29-15 before the score from Zimmerman. Alaska with just two scores in the books. Sarah Luttrell will be up next for the Hornets. Another one of their freshmen. We've seen a lot of them throughout the season so far. Luttrell this year opened with a 9.75. She was NPSF Freshman of the Week that week against UC Davis. Went all around, had two scores above a 9.725 in that competition. Last week had a little bit of issues, 9.5 on vault, had a fall on bars as well, but ended with a 9.725 on floor as well. So she has shown the ability to go above 9.7 in all four events this season. Just a freshman, local product from Citrus Heights, trained at Byers here in Sacramento. But it's going to be a little bit of a longer break on bars as the judges confirm. Sometimes with these falls, it can lead to a long discussion based off of what gets counted, what gets goes as connection, what bonuses involved in this process. And
absolutely. We saw her miss her release move, and when you do that, there's a few things. Not only does it automatically mean the 5/10 deduction for the fall, but the judges really have to look for that split-second moment if her hands touched the bar. If they touched the bar and it was truly just a fall, that's the 5/10. If they didn't touch the bar, she doesn't get credit for the skill, and that's where that strange start value credit discussion comes into play.
So it looks like it's going to be an 8.15 for Emily Walker. It is a 9.1 from Zimmerman for Sacramento State. And now we will see Haley Perkins.
Beautiful handstands. Haley is a taller gymnast, which I think is absolutely stunning on an event like uneven bars. You really get those long lines. Just a hair short on that handstand, a little bit loose in her body position, wasn't able to generate enough momentum on the swing. Unfortunately, another fall on bars for Alaska Anchorage.
The third consecutive fall for the Seawolves. Not the start they were looking for to try to get going here and try to pick up their first win of the season. The Hornets, that score for Zimmerman was a 9-2. And so Sacramento State will be looking to not count that score so far. Right now, 9.725 for Lamidi, a 9.75 for Fitzgerald, a 9.675 for Tavner in the books. And then Luttrell and Morgenthaler still to go for the Hornets.
We will see Haley attempt that same combination. It was a part of her dismount. Was able to make it through that time. A small step on the double back.
We'll jump quickly back over to vault. Sarah Luttrell is down the runway.
Beautiful Yurchenko layout full from Sarah. She is stunning on this event. That high-flying action off the table. She gets amazing height, amazing distance, perfect body position in the air. Looks to be a big score.
Just a little bit of a tiny step on that right foot that stepped back. But other than that, a beautiful vault from Sarah Luttrell. Possibly flirting with the season high here in the early going. And put the Hornets right back on track for another score in that 48 range for Sacramento State, as they will have one gymnast still to go. It will be Emma Morgenthaler. You can hear the teammates chanting for her all the way down to the other end of the runway. Morgenthaler, the very talented redshirt sophomore, came to Sacramento State in 2021. Hornets opted out of that season. She did not compete, and then made her debut last year, qualified for the NCAA Regionals, and has developed into a pretty solid all-arounder for Sacramento State here in her second season.
Yes, Emma is very fun to watch. She isn't necessarily what you may think of that captivating college gymnast personality, but she is so even keel. I think that she is the Tom Brady of Sac State Gymnastics. Doesn't get rocked by many things. She is a perfect anchor for a lot of different events. She's a perfect leadoff for a lot of different events. Just for that same reason, though, that she doesn't let a lot of things affect her. She's not a very emotional gymnast. She just goes out there, does what she knows how to do, and more than likely will hit the routine every time.
Might have another conference. Nope, we're going to say go ahead on bars. It was just about a 3/10 separation. Anything over 3/10, they have to confer. We will get the score for Haley Perkins. This is Paolo Ruano Barana.
A little bit of some form breaks throughout this routine. Again, the judges are looking for perfection, so those tight, squeezed legs together, pointed toes, there will be some deductions, but a great way for the Seawolves to get back on track with a made routine.
The score for Sarah Fitzgerald is going to be a 9-8, excuse me, for Sarah Luttrell, a 9-8. This is Morgenthaler.
Again, a lot of power. Beautiful Yurchenko, 1.5. That's where that big start value comes in for the Hornets. Perfect for that anchor spot. Just a small hop forward on the landing.
Here's the replays we see here.
A very difficult vault to stick. It's a blind landing, so she doesn't see the floor until the very, very moment her feet hit. I know it's something that she works really hard for, to try to find that stick. I'm sure it will come soon this season.
The 9-8 for Luttrell was a career high through three meets. And Sacramento State right now sitting at a 48-1-5 before the score of Morgenthaler comes in. So it should be a pretty significant improvement for the Hornets, as right now they are counting the 9-2. Alaska Anchorage currently at a 34-8. And they still have one score out to be turned in, and then Rachel Deschus will anchor the lineup, as well as an exhibition coming. Sacramento State, the season 48-4-7-5. We said 48-3-5 this year. There are two scores, so 48-1-5, counting a 9-2, I would imagine that's going to put them above their season high. I'd be shocked if Emma received anything below a 9-5 for that vault.
Not likely.
And we're going to confer again over on bars, as there's a 4.5-10 separation between what was shown. A long first rotation here. Doesn't seem to dampen the spirits of the Seawolves, though. They're having a good time.
They found some pom-poms. I'm not sure if those are their pom-poms or Sac State's. They have very similar colors.
They came with them. They arrived. Must have been packed in their carry-on. But
love it.
They are both teams green and gold. Hornets in their black Leos this year. If you can't tell on the broadcast, it's Sac across the chest in rhinestone. Alaska Anchorage in the white, black, and green.
Anchor spot for Alaska Anchorage. Rachel opens up with a beautiful release combination. A little short on that handstand. Has to do a little extra pirouette and is able to hold on to that dismount. Did not quite get the height that she warmed up with on the dismount, but hangs on and takes a small step on the landing.
The routine before for Barana, 9.125. For Sacramento State on vault, it was a 9.8 for Emma Morgenthaler. And so Sacramento State will conclude vault with a 48.75, their season high, and a perfect start to their meet tonight for what the Hornets were trying to do, get back on track. Right now, Alaska at a 43.925, but they will hopefully add on to that. Decius' score will replace one of the falls, and they still have one exhibition still to come in this rotation. It will be Brianne Spain. For the Hornets, you have the score in the books that you wanted, a very strong start for Sacramento State. Now you go to the two events that kind of been a thorn in your side. How much of it's mental, how much of it's physical at this point?
I lean more towards the mental side. These athletes train day in and day out. Gymnastics training is all about repetition. So they do these skills time and time again, so that when they hit the competition floor, it is second nature. So they know how to do it. They know how to put it all together. They just have to show up, take that momentum that they built over on vault, two uneven bars, two balance beam, and just continue to build. They don't need to score. They don't need to set a school record in any of these events. They just need to keep building on the momentum that they set the first event.
Surprisingly, we have another conference between the judges. Nope. As they will discuss the score for Rachel Decius. .48750, the score for Sacramento State. One of their, well, obviously the best of the season, but best in a while. Looking at the school top 10 for vault is 10th place, 49.05. So the Hornets not that far off. If they can clean up some of those landings you talked about, that's, you know, they probably gave up 3 to 4 tenths alone just on the dismounts and the landing. Not that far out of the range of being able to get into that 49 possibilities.
Absolutely. And with that little bit of a hiccup in the middle of their lineup with Rylan, she's a competitor who gets that height, the distance off the table. That could really increase their scores as well. Ultimately, or your typical situation is dropping that leadoff spot. So if your leadoff spot's opening with the 9.7, 9.75 consistently and you're scoring above that, there's a lot of promise in your lineup.
You want to see those scores build from the start to the finish. The final score for Decius is a 9.45, and we will give you the total here in a second.
Very interesting release. I have been out of the sport of gymnastics for a number of years, so don't quote me on what that skill is called. A very unique routine for Alaska. There's a lot of opportunities for the Seawolves to clean up their routines. Again, you never want a fall, and you especially don't want three falls in a night, so they have a lot of chances to build this year.
So we are through the first rotation. Sacramento State with about a little over a three-point lead. The Hornets 48.75 on vault. Alaska Anchorage 45.225 on vault. bars. The teams will flip-flop. The Hornets will head off to bars for the second rotation. The Seawolves will come to vault. We'll take the break. We'll come back with a look at a couple of the highlights and the second rotation. You're watching NCAA Gymnastics on ESPN+. Back here at the Nest, you can see the scores on the screen. Sacramento State 48-75 season high. Alaska-Anchorage 45-225. Very strong start for Sacramento State, not the start that Anchorage is looking for. Here are a few of the highlights as Sarah Fitzgerald and Tori Tavner. It's Alaska on bars. Sarah Luttrell, who had the career high, and a near stick for Luttrell. She tied with Emma Morgenthaler for the high in the event, as Luttrell and Morgenthaler each with a 9-8, Fitzgerald with a 9-7-5. For Sacramento State this year, if I am not mistaken, I believe that is the Morgenthaler at a 9-8-2-5. That is the high this season overall, but they are the Emma's now done it twice. Luttrell broke 9-8 for the first time this season tonight. So a good start there. The Hornets will now focus on bars. We said bars has been a bit of an adventure. Both meets, it's been a bit of an up and down campaign this year for Sacramento State on bars. The Hornets this season, 47-5-5 at home and then 47-5-7-5 at Oregon State last week. But we said it was not the same gymnast that basically had the miscues. And so a chance to put it all together if it goes well. And we will see where they're at.
Absolutely. The Hornets have looked strong throughout warmups tonight. It's just a matter, like we touched on earlier, of putting it all together.
Bars this year, team currently being coached by former Hornet Megan Kyle, serving as the volunteer assistant, former bar specialist herself. She's working as the coach, Nicole Brandt, also another former Hornet, out on maternity leave. She'll be back fairly soon. I know she pops in the gym from time to time, but it has both of them, I think, scratching their head of what the inconsistencies so far this year, and they'd love to see the team put it together. Anchorage a chance to move over to vault and see if they can get back on track after a rough showing on bar to start the meet as well. We'll set the lineups for you here in the second rotation. And it will be Ariana D'Souza, followed by Celia Hildebrand, Allie McClure, Madeline Gomez, Montana Fairbairn, and Alyssa Manley for the Seawolves. For Sacramento State, it will be Tori Tavner, Kara Houghton, Emma Morgenthaler, Sarah Luttrell, Bella Lamitti, Amber Koth, and then Grace Gilman slated for an exhibition. I know they are kind of resting Grace a little bit in this meet, and she will expect a likely four events on Sunday.
Getting started right away on vault for the Seawolves is Ariana D'Souza with the Yurchenko layout. Landed with her chest just a little bit low on the landing and a small step.
Here's the replay. Just a tiny step forward with that right foot, but a good start. Quickly on bars, we are underway on that apparatus as well. This is Tori Tavner.
Beautiful combination. She was a little bit short on the handstands. The judges are looking for just a small window of that perfect 90 degrees. Big windup, beautiful double layout dismount. Strong start for the Hornets. They will look to build on that.
You'll see Sacramento State, a lot of very short bar routines packed full with the skills needed, but a lot of the mentality of getting on and getting off as fast as you can and getting all the boxes checked as far as the skills go.
Absolutely. We've seen that a lot throughout college gymnastics this season. Those short routines, sort of guaranteed to stick, guaranteed to hit, and again, minimizing any opportunity for deduction.
Yeah, 9-4-7-5 on vault to start for the Seawolves from D'Souza. This will be Hildebrand up next.
Getting some last second encouragement.
Sophomore from Yakima and a very short run up, as you will see on the approach here.
Every gymnast has their certain number of steps. She does that front entry onto the table. Sort of a pike, sort of a tuck. We'll see what her start value is, what the judges determine that to be.
Also question whether the landing will count or is she able to save it? We will not see.
I wasn't able to quite tell from our angle if she did in fact sit or just that really low squat. In any case, it's somewhere between a 3/10 and a 5/10 deduction.
Kara Houghton, one of the other freshmen for Sacramento State, she will go second, following a 9-7-2-5 from Tori Tavner.
Kara opens her routine with a beautiful release. Right to a big pack salto down to the low bar. Kara has a beautiful toe point, nice extension, good handstand right there. Again, a beautiful double layout, the tiniest little step forward on the landing. This is the sort of momentum we were talking about. The Hornets just need to keep doing exactly this, hitting those handstands, hitting those releases, not getting ahead of themselves.
Two for two for Sacramento State. It'll be Allie McClure up third for the Seawolves. You talked about the different length on the approaches on vault. Most gymnasts towards the back of the runway. Is that just more steps, more speed, and more speed, more power? Is that the difference?
It's really preference. I think a lot of gymnasts like the more steps, more speed mentality. But I've also had teammates who have truly counted how many steps it takes. And so if it only makes sense to take 13 steps in their brain, that's what they're going to stick to. I preferred running a little bit further. Sometimes it also has to do in what sort of gym you trained in. Maybe your runway was a little bit shorter growing up. We had a very long one when I was a young gymnast.
Hildebrand before, one of the shortest I've seen in college gymnastics. This is McClure.
Ali Yurchenko tuck full. Quite off to the left side of the mat on that. I think she stepped off both feet out of the boundary of the mat.
And the Morgenthaler up third for Sacramento State.
Emma was able to save that first handstand. Nice release. A little short on that. That is one area. Bella is very consistent. However, she could improve on those handstands on this event. A nice one there. Just the dismount left. A very, very difficult double layout with that full out. The most difficult dismount you'll see in competition tonight. Just a small, small step on the landing.
Kara Houghton, a 9.725 for Sacramento State before Morgenthaler went. And for Hildebrand, it was a 9.15.
Madeline Gomez up now for the Seawolves. Yurchenko tuck full. A nice vault, just a small little hop back on the landing.
Look at the replay. In 1 foot stick.
We talked about start values for the Hornets on vault. You see these Yurchenko tuck fulls. They will start from a little bit of a lower start value than we saw from the Hornets over on vault. That combined with a few of those small little detailed mistakes is why you're seeing those lower scores.
To go back over to bars as we await the score for Morgenthaler. This will be Sarah Luttrell. And for Morgenthaler, it will be a 9.7. A 9.25 for Allie McClure for Alaska.
Sarah is a beautiful bar worker. Again, a little bit taller, so you get those beautiful long lines. Just ever so slightly short on all of her handstands. One of my very favorite bar release moves right there. She does it beautifully. Winding up for that dismount. Full twisting double back. A bigger step back on that landing. But the Hornets are 4 for 4 so far on bars.
Yeah, they're definitely looking to build up that momentum we saw on vault. We'll go back over to vault for the Seawolves is Montana Fairbairn.
Again, that interesting entry, that full twist onto the table, a pike off. It was actually very well executed, just landing with that chest just a little bit low. It's very difficult to land your chest all the way forward on that vault.
So both teams right now with 3 scores and halfway through. The Hornets at a 29-1-5. Alaska 27-8-7-5 midway through. And we will await. await the scores of the next two for Alaska. Up next for Sacramento State, it will be Bella Lamitti.
I'm on right now.
And then Amber Koth to anchor.
I was on right there.
Wait, scores come in. For Sacramento State, it will be a 9-7-2-5 for Luttrell. So again, the Hornets pacing nicely, as that is another career high for Luttrell, followed her career high on vault. And then a 9-6 for Madeline Gomez for Alaska, their highest score on vault.
Bella Lamitti now for the Hornets on bars. Opens with that beautiful Jaeger two shoot over down to the low bar. Another short and sweet routine. She'll do a full pirouette into a double tuck. Small step back on the landing. 5 for 5. This is what we wanted to see from Sacramento State tonight.
Be Alyssa Manley anchoring for Alaska Anchorage.
A Yurchenko layout. She just came in really, really low onto that table and wasn't able to get enough block, push, and height to get that rotation around. Has to put her hands down.
You could tell immediately that just not the height, as you said, coming off the board. Shoulders were almost on the shoulders and head almost on the table as she was pushing off. So that will go as a fall for the Seawolves. Still might improve their team score. They're currently counting at 9-1-5. We'll see where the judges finish on Manley. Sacramento State will wrap up the competitive part of their lineup with Amber Koth. And then Grace Gilman looks like she will go on exhibition following Amber's routine.
Amber, the senior, a great person to have in this anchor spot. A lot of experience. A beautiful gymnast. Perfect toe point, perfect body position in everything that she does. She starts with that chapeau up to the high bar, straight into that shoot over, down to the low bar. Slightly short on those handstands. Full pirouette, double tuck. Hangs on to stick the landing. That's the exclamation point we've been waiting for all evening.
It was a 9-7-2-5 for Lamitti. That took the Hornets to a 48-6. And possibly even higher following that routine from Koth. The low score for Sacramento State, a 9-7. So don't expect a huge jump for Fairbairn, a 9-6-2-5. Gives Alaska 47-1 right now on vault. And then we will get the score for Manley to complete their rotation. There will be no exhibition on vault. So one more to go on bars for Sacramento State. It will be Grace Gilman. We come up on the halfway point of the meet. And the Hornets in a very nice position, 97.35 their score right now before the score of Koth. So tracking towards that 194, high 194 range is Sacramento State.
Like we touched on right before this rotation, this is what Sacramento State needed to do. They didn't need to focus on high scores. They just needed to hit their routine, get one rotation of bars under their belt, 6 for 6, and that's exactly what they did. They can definitely build on that for Sunday.
This is Grace Gilman with a huge release.
Beautiful. Grace is so powerful on this event. It will be great to have her back in the lineups.
Thank you.
Full twisting pirouette into a double back. 7 for 7, if you include the exhibition. That's exactly what the coaches and the team wanted to see tonight.
So that will wrap up the second rotation. We are halfway through this meet. Alyssa Manley finished with an 8-8 on vault for the Seawolves. And that gives Alaska Anchorage a team score of 92-325 for Sacramento State and 9-7-5 for Amber Cope. And so the Hornets go to a 48-6-5 as they pick up their season high on bars. Sacramento State leading right now by over 5 points, 97-4 to 97-325 through two rotations. The Hornets will go to beam. Alaska Anchorage will start the third rotation on floor. When we come back, you're watching NCAA Gymnastics here on ESPN+. Back here at the Nest, midway through this meet, Sacramento State with a 5-point lead. The Hornets 97-4 to 92-325. There was a slight improvement, so that total score goes up by a half a tenth for Sacramento State after the Amber Koth vault. It was a 9-6-5 the score for Grace Gilman on the exhibition, so another point to move forward with for Sacramento State. But now the challenge will come. We look at the highlights, first of all, from that second rotation for both teams. Anchorage, the team that does compete at Division I, they're Division II for all other sports, Division I for gymnastics, in the MPSF with Sacramento State. And a program that had some struggles and really found some life when Tanya Ho took over as the head coach, and then now Marie Sophie Bogosh was the top assistant for Tanya when she was there, and as trying to keep this program going, did a fantastic job of saving the program. Looked like it was going to be cut, raised a lot of money up there to save the program, keep them alive, and they are trying to get back to a competitive stature in the MPSF, which right now is being dominated by San Jose State this year. Spartans, who the Hornets will see on Sunday, off to a very good start to the year through two meets.
Alaska has a lot of potential. They have some difficulty. They have the opportunity to put up big scores. We just saw, you know, unfortunately, them open the meet with quite a few falls. That puts you automatically behind. And then just continue that sort of trend on vault as well. So, again, early in the year, they travel a lot, like we noted in the beginning tonight. So it's just a matter of them getting into a rhythm, and I think that they will see some success towards the end of the year.
Yeah, skills are there, at least the level of difficulty in the routines. It's just a matter of trying to find that consistency. Saw close on a few of the vaults, just chest down on some of the landings. You had a squat on one of the landings. So some things that could be cleaned up going forward as they head towards the MPSF Championships this year, which will take place at Air Force. And then Sacramento State will now will go to Beam, which, like Bars, has been a real big question mark for the team. It's always the great equalizer in any meet, is you can make or break a team's night. And talking to Melissa Genovese, who is the former Hornet current school record holder on Beam, the Beam coach for Sacramento State, keeps talking about how the potential's there. They hit in practice and just haven't been unable to do it so far in competition. And for the Hornets right now, on pace to get a high 194, near 195 score, it's essential they hit on Beam tonight.
Absolutely. Beam, for any team across the country, any level, is that make or break event. And the Hornets historically have been very, very strong on Beam and still show so much potential on this event. So again, they train these skills day in and day out. It's just a matter of taking that feeling that they have at practice and translating it into the competition environment.
We're going to go to the third rotation. It will be Grace Gilman, Emma Morgenthaler, Rylan Zimmerman, Sarah Luttrell, Peyton Gillen, Amber Koth, Ruby Mack will make her debut this year as an exhibition. It'll be Gilman leading off for the Hornets. She performed exhibition on bars, so the last one up on bars, first one up on beam. Any challenges with that?
It's a quick turnaround. I personally liked it. It was, you sort of keep that momentum. She hit on bars, so she can take that positive energy right to the balance beam.
There is a 6 minute plus break built in now between the two. Not that she had a run from one to the other, but.
Strong start so far. We saw a bit of a balance check after her back handspring, back layout step out. Beautiful side aerial right there. Solid leap combination. The judges are looking for that perfect 180 degree split. She was a little short on both jumps. See, just a slight deduction on that. Should just be the dismount. Round off 1.5. Big hop forward on the landing, but a strong start. That's exactly what you want in your leadoff position, is a hit routine for the other gymnast to continue to build that momentum.
Anchorage will be up first on floor. Will be Madeline Gomez. Trying to have some issues with their music right now as they try to get ready to go. We're going to have Maddie Gomez step off, regroup as they try to get the music to go. Teams go through all this during their touch warm-up. So obviously it was working earlier. And now we will see Gomez.
Madeline will start her routine with a double tuck. Floor exercise is the one event where you get to see a little bit more of the gymnast personality. Saw her do a little worm as a part of her choreography. Good leaps. Again, perfection is the name of the game. So pointed toes, straight legs, all areas that are easy to clean up for these gymnasts as they progress through the season. final tumbling pass. Round off 1.5 front layout, just loose on those legs. You saw just a slight knee bend on both of those skills. Small deduction.
So decent start for Anchorage on floor from Maddie Gomez. Sacramento State receives a 9.725 from Grace Gilman on beam. And for her, that is a season high, just off her career high of 9.775. And now it's Emma Morgenthaler up for Sacramento State.
Emma starts off with that very impressive wolf turn. Back handspring, back layout step out, stuck beautifully. Once again, calm, cool, and collected for Emma. This is an event that's very hard to be all three of those things, but she makes it look very easy. Switch leap to a back tuck, a little low on that landing. Dismount, round off 1.5, beautiful stuck landing. She's excited about that one. You don't see her show a lot of emotion, but a big smile, big hug from her teammates.
Morgenthaler's season high is a 9.675. You would have to think that is gonna fall tonight. Her career high last year, 9.775. So depending on how generous the judges are gonna be, we will find out. Up next on floor for Alaska Anchorage will be Mackenzie Robinson.
Next on floor for Alaska is Mackenzie Robinson.
And again, we're going to have some music issues here.
Mackenzie does not look like that little music stumble bothered her at all. Very focused to start this routine. Opens with a big double tuck. Beautiful switch side. Second tumbling pass, round off 1.5 front layout. Beautiful combination. Another hit routine for the Seawolves on floor exercise.
So Mackenzie Robinson done. Maddie Gomez's score was a 9.5. Emma Morgenthaler, a career best 9.825 for Sacramento State. And now Rylan Zimmerman, the freshman, up.
A beautiful display of strength with that press to handstand mount. side aerial just lands with her chest low, and it's really hard to stabilize your body, your feet, if you're off just a little bit. So comes off. Quickly then has to transition into that big acro series, backhand spring, back layout, step out. Handles it beautifully. Beautiful leaps. You see that full extension. Round off 1.5 dismount. Lands a little stiff. Has to take that step back. Hopefully the Hornets can come back after that fall and not have to count a fall on balance beam.
Tough night for Ryland Zimmerman, her two routines, but a chance to bounce back. That quick turnaround could come at a good time for her. Back on it on Sunday, better regroup. Just a freshman, part of this talented freshman class of Sacramento State, was 4, now down to 3. Olivia Schmidt suffered the injury that will keep her up for the rest of the year, but we saw 4 in this home opener in the lineup and competing. And now will be Allie McClure for the Seawolves.
Very fun start to this routine. Allie will open with a round off double tuck. Very difficult. You don't get that power from that back handspring. She just goes straight into it. Big leap combination. Just a little short on the extension in her first leap. Quickly into her second tumbling pass. Round off 1.5. Dances out of it. Not sure if that was meant to be a combination pass. And again, very quickly into her third tumbling pass. Round off 1.5. Punch front. For 3 for Alaska, showing that even though they had some stumbles in those first two events, they're not letting it affect them on floor exercise.
Mackenzie Robinson at a 9.675, the routine before that. Ryland Zimmerman at 9.05 for the Hornets, and now this is Sarah Luttrell. Already 2 career highs tonight.
Let's see if she can continue that momentum on balance beam. Back handspring, back layout, step out, slight balance check. Nice leap combination. Side aerial. A big deep breath, that dismount, side aerial into a 1.5. Beautiful stuck landing. She is on fire tonight.
Sarah Luttrell, season high on beam, her career high, 9.525. That will likely go down. She might be 3 for 3 in career highs to start this meet, just the 3rd meet of her career. But a excellent start to the year for Sarah Luttrell, the freshman from Citrus Heights. Trained at Byers Roseville, and a local product that is really doing her part of carrying the Hornets here in the early part of the season.
It's very encouraging to see these freshmen in lineups, especially early on in the year. They come in, you not only have to adjust to college gymnastics, but just to college life, and what it's like to compete in front of a home crowd, to travel, to be on the road every other weekend. And it's very nice to see that these ladies have just stepped in, shown that they have value and can be relied upon in these lineups.
It'll be Ariana D'Souza up next for the Seawolves. Judges are conferring on the score for Allie McClure.
And I also think over on balance beam as well. We talk about the fact that it's early in the year for the gymnasts. It's early in the year for the judges as well.
We are screened out a little bit by Anchorage that's in front of us, but the one judge score flashed to 9.85 for Luttrell. I'm not sure what the other one is, but that's at least a good half score for sure.
Absolutely. If the excitement is any indication, I'm guessing it is a career high.
Ariana D'Souza.
Ariana will start off her routine with a front tumbling pass as a front handspring into a front double full. That is an E-level skill, which gives her a good amount of bonus. Deep breath before that second tumbling pass. Front handspring, front one and a half. A nice leap combination, switch side into that straddle full. One final pass for Ariana. Round off one and a half, front layout, beautiful landing. Great routine from Ariana D'Souza.
So that puts Alaska Anchorage back on track. It was a 9.85 for Sarah Luttrell. And so now Peyton Gillen will be fifth up for Sacramento State. What a night for Sarah Luttrell. Still one more event to go, but three career highs in a night. I know it's early in the season, but pretty remarkable.
Early in the season or not, and you have a night where you're hitting your routines and setting career highs, it definitely is a huge confidence booster. Backhand spring, back layout step out, beautiful finish. I love the way that Peyton accentuates all of her finishes, all of her landings. That essence of confidence not only helps her compete, but I think it also shows the judges that there is no doubt, that they shouldn't have any doubt in the deductions and anything like that. Beautiful leap series. A little stingers up right before the dismount. A front tuck full, stuck landing. The Hornets have found that momentum that we were hoping for tonight. Big exclamation points on these already hit routines on balance beam.
Peyton Gillen went 9.9 last year. That was her career high. Her high this season, 9.675. Hornets coaches really felt like she got shorted last week at Oregon State and received a 9.675. Thought the routine was much better than what the judges gave her. But a strong, strong performance from Peyton Gillen. We'll go back over to floor now for Alaska Anchorage. This is Alyssa Manley.
The Seawolves also looking to build the momentum after that hit routine from Ariana just before her. Alyssa opens, big double pike, a little stiff on that landing. Little encouragement from her teammates on the sidelines. Round off 1.5 step out, right into another 1.5. That is a fun combination pass. A little short on those leaps. The judges are looking not only for that full extension in the air, but also for the leaps to finish exactly where they should. So she undercut it just a little bit. We'll see if she gets the bonus for the full 1.5.
Peyton Gillen scored a 9.8. This will be Amber Coth anchoring the lineup for Sacramento State. She is the best beam worker on the team. And arguably one of the best in school history. Only trails associate head coach Melissa Genovese on the all-time list.
Absolutely. And I think both Amber and Melissa would love nothing more than for her to beat Melissa's record. She definitely has the potential, showing it right there with that big triple series back handspring. Back layout step out into a back handspring, takes the full length of the balance beam. I've seen it many, many times, and it never is any less impressive.
Or scary. She's about 5 inches or less to work with on the back end of that beam.
Amber has beautiful leaps. Miraculously is able to hang on. That second foot did not even make it on the balance beam, but that's just a testament to her strength, to her competitiveness, showing her flexibility. Just the dismount, she'll do a back handspring, a gainer layout full, stuck landing.
Just the one mistake. It will be a deduction there, but it still will be an improvement. The Hornets will not count the fall they had early on. They will have a season high on beam, or already sitting at a 48.25, which would have been the season high with counting the fall. But it should be a big score for Sacramento State, and my guess would put them in that mid 48 range. And so the hits keep on coming right now for Sacramento State tonight, as they are off to a fantastic start. One event still to go for the Hornets. They do have the exhibition from Ruby Mack, who is a gymnast the Hornets have wanted to see up on beam. Another one of the long gymnasts.
These exhibitions are especially important when the Hornets have these back-to-back meets. We talked about the 3 meets in 8 days. There might be an opportunity for somebody to take a little bit of rest in one of these meets, save their body for later in the year, and these exhibitions can prove really important for adjusting those lineups as they need.
Yeah, especially the all-arounders. You'll see the event specialist, you know, they'll perform their 1 or 2 routines every week, but the all-arounders going 4 routines today, 4 routines Sunday. You're seeing from Emma Morgenthaler and Sarah Luttrell tonight. That'll be difficult to come around and do it 2 days in a row, especially Emma, I think, who has such powerful skills. It's very explosive, and it would be tough to do on a short rest. Obviously, you guys do it every day in the gym when you train it and have since a very young age. So it's something you're not used to doing, but competition seems to be a little bit different than practice.
Absolutely. Not only do you have just so much more adrenaline, and you're giving your all into every ounce of every routine, but the surfaces are a little bit different. When you're in the gym, you try to train on a competition surface a few times a week just to get that feel, but you also want to save your body. These gymnasts have been training their entire lives, and there's constant aches and pains, so those softer landings in the gym definitely help. Whereas when you're competing in back-to-back meets on the weekend, it's that back-to-back full intensity, full routines on those hard surfaces, and it gets to be a lot, especially if you have those nagging aches and pains.
Rachel Decius to anchor the lineup for the Seawolves. They will also have an exhibition coming.
Opens with a punch, front Rudy, that 1.5 twist. Another front tumbling pass, front layout to a front full. Quickly into her final tumbling pass, barely enough time to take a break. Round off 1.5, front layout, just over rotated that 1.5 a little bit, and it's very hard to then get the height on that second skill.
I think somehow she was able to save that from being a fall though.
I do think she was.
That was Rachel Decius for Alaska. Alyssa Manley received a 9.525 before that. Sacramento State ended that routine with their rotation with a 9.8 from Amber Koth, and the Hornets finish with a 49 even on beam, well above their season high. And so Sacramento State in a very good position. This is Ruby Mack on exhibition.
Ruby starts her routine with that acro series, back handspring, back layout, step out. Just a slight knee bend in both of those skills.
Always interesting to hear the beam music that they pick. Most gymnasts go for a little more soothing, calming music when they're up on beam. Ruby playing a little Red Hot Chili Peppers here.
The beam song is always fun. Definitely not required, but it is something that just helps the gymnasts calm their nerves when they're at a home meet. Makes it a little bit more fun for the crowd. I always like something a little bit more calming.
Unable to land that leap series.
She was just a little short. It's easier when your feet are completely sideways on the beam. She was at a little bit of an angle. Gainer layout full, another stuck landing. Even though she had the fall, saved that exclamation point for the very end of the rotation.
One more exhibition to come. It will be on floor. It will be Sydney Thomas Luch Medial. Wrapping up this third rotation. Still waiting on the final score for Decius right now. Seawolves at 47, 6-5 on floor. That is counting a 9-3, so they will probably get a little bit of a bump there.
Tumbling pass for Sydney. She'll start with a roundoff back handspring, double pike. Good height, but a big step back. She takes that step out of bounds. Probably at least a 2/10 deduction for the step, and then that extra 10th for the step out of bounds. Beautiful extension on that leap. Second tumbling pass, round off, 1.5, front pike. Perhaps stepped out of bounds there too. We were blocked a little bit. Sydney's a very powerful gymnast. She gets good height, good distance, just has to be able to control that. One final pass for this rotation. A round off through to a double tuck. Does not get enough rotation. Comes down pretty hard. Looks to be okay though.
Rachel Decius finished with a 9.425, and so Anchorage finishes with a 47.775 on floor. Ruby Mack with an 8.95 for the Hornets in her exhibition. And so the Hornets will take a sizable lead into the final rotation. They try to enter the last bit of scores in here. And so Sacramento State leads by 5.3 points, 146-4, 140.1. Hornets will try to close it out on floor with a chance to go big tonight. A high score on floor will give them a chance to flirt with a 195. You're watching NCAA Gymnastics here on ESPN Plus. Back here at the Nest, Sacramento State coming off of a season-high 49.00 on beam. And right now sitting at 146.4. These are some of the highlights from that rotation. Oh, saw it for a second. Here we go. Back to the highlights. Really just an all-around strong performance for Sacramento State. Had a fall, was able to put that behind him and move on, which is something that has plagued them here in the early part of the season. And a big number. Anytime you can break 49 on any event, it is a strong team score.
Absolutely. One of the biggest things we saw from the Hornets were those stuck landings. We talked about it earlier in the broadcast, just how important all of those little details are. And when you stick the landing, it really just shows the judges that extra bit of confidence. It leaves them with a little bit of a smile. You see that little bit of a bigger score because there really is nothing else that they can add on to that judging sheet. And it was very impressive to see, I think, 4 out of 6 gymnasts stick their landing. An extra stick if you include that exhibition routine as well.
Anchorage as well with their meet high, 47.775, their highest of any of their first three events as well. They were led on floor with a 9.675 from Mackenzie Robinson, who went second in their lineup. But it is the Hornets right now on pace for a big number as they are trying to get up into that 195 range. It is not a score that it comes frequently for Sacramento State. As we look at the team records right now, the school record 196.475, which came against San Jose State back in 2016. But 195.4 is 10th place in school history. And you're on a few teams that hit that number as well. But it you start getting that 195 range, you're up there with some of the better teams. The Sacramento State should be competing with that. We don't expect them at this point in time to be up there competing with the Oklahomas and Utahs of the world. But a 195 would put you in competitive against pretty much any meet that you're in the rest of the year.
Absolutely. We're seeing, you know, conference competitor San Jose State, UC Davis, nearing those marks, if not meeting them meet after meet. So it's really important that Sacramento State also shows up in that way if they want to be competitive for a conference championship this year.
Really, if you're unfamiliar with how gymnastics postseason works, it is a complicated formula that involves taking your top 6 scores. 3 of them have to be a minimum of 3 have to be away from home, maximum of 3 from home. You drop your high score, you average your next 5, and then the top 36 teams in the country advance to the postseason. So those first 2 meets of the year, very unfortunate for Sacramento State. Obviously 2 they wouldn't count, put you in a deep hole because you can't afford really to have any more mistakes. However, if you're capable of performing like they're performing tonight, you could be in a chance to contend for one of those top 36 spots, but it would require everything to continue down this path. So season is a complicated one in gymnastics. It is a much, momentum plays a big factor in it, but the Hornets showing tonight what they've been, the coaches have been preaching all year, that it has the potential to be a good scoring team, and we just hadn't seen it in the first 2 weeks, but on display this evening here against Anchorage. Floor has been a decent event for the team this year. Haven't shown the ability to go super high, but they have been consistent on floor as well. And I would say compared to the championship teams that you remember of in years past, this team probably lacks a little bit of the performance elements that you see. The athleticism is there, the skills are there, but not quite the dance routine we'll see it. Right now it's Anchorage up first on beam, and this is Montana Fairbairn.
A really strong start in this routine. You see Montana adding a little bit of a smile. Not something you see out of many beam workers, but it just shows that extra bit of confidence that she has in the leadoff position on this event. Back handspring, balances through to that side aerial, counts as her acro series. Just the dismount, She'll finish with a front full, step forward on the landing, but a hit routine to lead the Seawolves off on balance beam.
Alaska had those very difficult two rotations to start the meet that have been good on floor and now beam to start. And now Sacramento State will be Simone Dumas-Guzman. Hornets trying to find some help in this leadoff position too far through the two meets this year. Guzman exhibition, the first meet led off last week at Oregon State.
Simone will start her routine with a roundup back handspring, double tuck, lands with that chest just a little bit low. She's a beautiful dancer, very sharp, very fierce. A front one and a half, contrary to her first pass, over-rotates that one just a little bit, has to bounce out of it. Beautiful leap combination, great extension in both of those jumps. Tumbling pass for Simone. Front layout, front full, beautiful combination. A hit routine to lead the Hornets off. That's what they've been missing. That's what they were looking for to do tonight. May not be the highest score, but definitely something that the rest of the team can build on in this rotation.
Simone went 9.575 last week at Oregon State. She opened the year with an exhibition of a 9.5, so probably be in that range, maybe a little higher. We'll see what the start comes in for Sacramento State. It will be Brooklyn Kopczak up next for the Seawolves. Judges still conferring, though, on the Montana Fairbairn score, and so we'll have a bit of a break between now and then.
Most likely discussing that unique acro series that we saw. It's a delicate balance. I did something a little similar, something a little bit more unique that took some of that finesse, and it really is up to the judges to see if there was continuous motion. You want it to be a connection, not two separate skills, so that's most likely what they are discussing now.
And what's the penalty for not doing it?
So you lose the bonus, and you also lose a required combination. So the gymnast must compete that two acro skills to get credit as a part of your requirement, and then also because those were two more challenging skills, there was a bonus element too, which would bring that star value down pretty significantly.
How many more goals? Register broke apart, back together again. What this will end up being is a long break for both Kopczak as well as Anna Leroy for Sacramento State, as she will have to wait to go on floor until Kopczak goes on beam.
The judges definitely don't like those breaks in competition, but they do their very best to get everything 100% accurate, give the gymnast the score that they deserve.
Well, and we say that, now the floor judges are gonna confer, so.
They have the time.
Exactly. Anna Leroy doesn't seem too stressed either on this side, as she's having a nice conversation now with Randy Solario, before that joking around with her teammates.
I'm not sure that Anna's ever stressed. You'll see a lot of personality in her floor routine. She loves to dance. She loves to smile.
Hornets just happy to have her back. The score is in for Fairbairn, a 9-5-2-5, and now Kopczak will get set to go.
Little bit of a balance check there on that skill. Looked like she was going into a combination, so she'll do it again. Back handspring to a front toss, just a little off from the very beginning. You even saw in her dance, she was just a little unsure of herself. The beam is only 4 inches wide, so that's why confidence is so important. Anytime you're a little unsure, it just means a little bit extra room for mistakes. Dismount, gainer layout full, slightly off to the side on that landing, takes the step backwards. The Seawolves will hope to drop that score from their team total.
9-4-5 was the score for Simone Dumas-Guzman to start for Sacramento State. This will be Anna Leroy, the senior.
And we'll start off her routine with a big double twisting front full. Ends her pass with that big smile we were talking about. Great leap combination. Second tumbling pass, round off whip to a double twist. Just a little undercut in her rotation. Just the final pass. She'll finish with a front 1.5 to a stag jump. Maybe a slight deduction just for being a little out of control on that combination.
Good start for Sacramento State, 2-for-2 in hit routines on floor. Dumas Guzman and Leroy will go over to beam. This is Ariana D'Souza.
Starts her routine with that front toss to a back handspring step out. You've seen a lot of variety in those acro combinations from Alaska on balance beam. Short on those jumps. Again, perfect 180 degrees is what the judges are looking for. Ariana finishes with a front full. Stuck landing a little bit low.
Ariana D'Souza from Fairfield, about 45 miles away from Sacramento. Decent sized contingent on to watch her. Alaska has a couple of Northern California natives. Also, Maddie Gomez is from Dixon. Both of them trained at Dream Extreme Gymnastics over in the Bay. We'll have a chance. Thanks to all those fans watching across the country here tonight. Sacramento State Gymnastics. And Dallas, you have a special message from your fiance who said you're doing a great job and watching as well.
That is kind that he is tuning in.
While we have a moment, recognize this is your last meet broadcasting with us, so thank you for your time over the last 3 years. And we started this, or 4 years, we've been doing it a long time, and you guys are moving down to the Bay Area for a new job opportunity, and we thank you for all you've done for Sac State Athletics and all the knowledge you've brought to the broadcast as well.
It has been a pleasure. It has been so fun to sit here and still be a part of the program and to get to watch so many Hornets shine and have their moment right here in the nest in a place that means so much to me. It's been so fun to kind of live vicariously through the teams over the years.
Well, you are the good luck charm so far tonight. We'll see how Sacramento State finishes out this meet. Right now it is Kara Houghton, one of the freshmen.
Kara opens with a beautiful double pike. Exactly what the judges are looking for. A big height on her skill. Beautiful, slow and controlled landing. Great extension in her leaps. A front Rudy, again, nice controlled landing.
Those twisting skills, is it possible to actually stick that landing, or is your momentum just going too fast?
It is definitely possible, but that nice slow controlled step back is not a deduction. So it's a little bit easier on your body, a little bit easier mentally to just take that nice step back. Kara finishes her routine nice and strong.
Marcella Bonifaci quickly up on the beam for the Seawolves. Ariana D'Souza, 9.675. That's high for the team tonight.
She tried her very, very hardest to hang on to the beam. I saw her do that combination in warm-up so, so well. It was very hard, that side aerial straight into a second side aerial. We see most gymnasts just perform that skill as a standalone skill. She chooses to do it in combination, which is very difficult. Unfortunately, comes off the beam. Nice ring leap from Marcella. Just the dismount. A front gainer off the end of the beam. Nice landing. Disappointed, though, in that fall early on in her routine.
So that was the fourth routine for Alaska Anchorage. Now up for Sacramento State will be Sarah Luttrell, trying to see if she can go 4 for 4 in career highs.
Sarah looking to finish off nice and strong on floor exercise, opening her routine with a big double pike. A little encouragement from head coach Randy Solario before her second pass. front layout, front full. Extension on her leaps. We'd like to see those just get a little bit more height. But one final tumbling pass to cap off her big night. Big double tuck. Big smile on her face. She knows she's had a great night tonight.
9.725 is the score that she is chasing. She scored that last week at Oregon State. And we will see where she will finish off tonight. Chance also getting above a 39 in the all around as well, which would also be a career high. As an 8.75 the score for Bonifaci, and 9.625 the score for Kara Houghton for Sacramento State. And now up on beam is Paola Ruana Barana.
More smiles. I think I've seen every one of these Alaska gymnasts smile during their beam routine. Shows that even though they've had a rough night, they're staying true to who they are. They're having fun. They're learning. Just a dismount for Paola. Round off, 1.5, just a little bit of a knee bend and a slight hop back on the landing.
I believe the Latrell score was a 9.775, so she will go 4 for 4. And that will be Emma Morgenthaler for Sacramento State, also having a very good meet, looking to crack 39 in the all-around as well.
I think Emma, due to the fact that the Hornets are competing so much, will open her routine slightly different this meet. A front 1.5 to a beautiful back layout step out. She floats out of the sky on that skill.
The second pass is where we've seen her do the double layout. First Hornet in school history to do it. She is going to go to a double pike tonight.
Great leap combination. Just a double pike, I suppose, is the language we have to use, but it is a beautiful one. There's not many gymnasts in the country that just do a double pike, but she is one of them. Bit of a smile even to finish off the routine. A great night for Emma.
So Barona had a 9.45, Luttrell a 9.775, and now this is Rachel Decius anchoring for the Seawolves.
Rachel starting off her routine with a front aerial, slight balance check right there. Will reattempt as a part of her acro series She does that front aerial into a standing layout step out, right into that beep jump. Switch leap, split jump, nice strong finish on both of those skills. Dismount, front full, stuck landing. That's definitely the routine that Alaska wants to finish their night with.
That was Rachel Decius closing it out. Now for the Hornets in the anchor spot, Amber Koth, who is a firm believer for a little chalk is good, a lot of chalk is better.
Absolutely. Like we talked about earlier, Amber is a stunning gymnast, very intentional. We saw that on bars with her toe point, on beam with every skill that she does, and here on floor, both in that high flying tumbling, but then also in the choreography and her dance. Beautiful leap combination, that double cat, very difficult to execute well. Another beautiful leap combination. We talked about short and sweet routines. Amber's second and final tumbling pass, 1.5. To a beautiful front layout. I didn't see much deduction in that routine. We'll see if the judges agree.
Great way to end the night. Amber has come so far as a gymnast, as far as a performer on the floor. The skills have always been there, but you saw the performance value there. Another strong floor routine for Sacramento State, which will likely be close to their season high on floor. We'll check in a second here. Decius is going to finish the 9.725 on beam, so a very good ending for the Seawolves to this night. They still have the exhibition, which is up now in Mackenzie Robinson. Alaska was a 47.125 on beam.
Very, very difficult combination right there. A round off to a back layout. Those are skills you typically see on the floor exercise, not up on the balance beam.
It was a 9.825 for Emma Morgenthaler. It's going to be a 9.875 for Amber Koth. And Sacramento State is going to be about a 48.5, maybe a 48.5 plus here on floor, and finish the night at a 194.8-ish range. So very, very good performance for the Hornets.
A solid routine in exhibition from Mackenzie Robinson.
Bella Lamidi on floor for Sacramento State. Another one of those exhibition routines with a chance to work her way into the lineup.
Bella with that whip half to a 1.5 front full. Big deep breath from Bella, getting ready for that second pass. front handspring, 1.5. And a stinger's up to finish it off.
So that is going to wrap up the competition for tonight. We're going to take a short break. We'll come back and give you awards in a few minutes. But it is Sacramento State with a season high. We'll have the exact number coming up, but they are going to be near a 195, just short of a 195, and a big night for the Hornets. We will take a break. We'll come back for the award presentation and give you the numbers from tonight. This is NCAA Gymnastics on ESPN+. Back here at the Nest, Sacramento State and Alaska-Anchorage completing the night. And it was a big night for Sacramento State. Hornets finish with a 195-1, the highest score for the team this year, and one of the highest scores the Hornets have had in quite some time, just outside the school top 10 of 195-4. But Dallas, after a rough start to the season, good to see this team finally put it all together and not only show an improvement, but show a massive improvement.
Absolutely. This meet was huge for the Hornets. We talked about it at the beginning, how they have all the skills, they have all the routines, they just hadn't been able to put it together all in one meet on every event, and they were able to show that tonight. Again, there is still room for a lot of improvements, landings, handstands, little mishaps here and there. But ultimately, the Hornets showed up tonight. They felt confident. They performed in front of this home crowd and were able to get a big score.
Yeah, Sacramento State led by their two all-arounders who both went over a 39 in the all-around. In fact, they tied once again. Second time this year they've tied in the all-around. 39-1-5 for Sarah Luttrell, Emma Morgenthaler. We saw last year what Emma Morgenthaler can do on a nightly basis. She's a fantastic gymnast. But Sarah Luttrell, what a night for her. Four career highs.
Absolutely. And to have four career highs is amazing. But then just to be able to put all four routines together, especially going into this back-to-back meet situation, is just so encouraging for her. I think it'll be great for her for the rest of the season.
So Sacramento State finishes, as we said, with their high. We'll give you the award winners right now. In third place on vault was Sarah Fitzgerald. She scored a 9.75. Emma Morgenthaler, Sarah Luttrell tie for first on vault with a 9.8. On bars, it was Amber Koth winning it with a 9.75. Sarah Luttrell, the high on beam with a 9.85. Amber Koth wins floor with a 9.875, and then we already gave you the all-around. We're going to turn it over to our pay announcer, Richard Hafley, who will have the awards for you going forward.
Thank you. Thank you.